celebration as Joe Biden announces the following big impact change he will make as president. President-elect Joe Biden is clearly a focused man despite all the uncertainty surrounding his historic election win that we see him become the 46th president of the United States. Only one thing stands in the way of his walk to the Oval Office, and that is the decision by his competitor and current President Donald Trump, who has refused to accept defeat, thus filing a case in court to nullify Biden's win. Trump has maintained that the election was a total mess in terms of the counting and that votes were stolen to the advantage of Biden, something he says he won't let go easily as he has a team of lawyers waiting to prove his claims and convince the judges that Biden's win should be nullified. However, despite all that, Biden and the Vice President-elect Kamala Harris are, on the other hand, already working on their agendas to start delivering as soon as they get sworn in. And the latest announcement has left many Americans so happy with Biden in particular. Taking to Twitter on Monday night, Biden revealed that he and Kamala want to build the country back together and start higher wages, which will include at 15% minimum wage for all workers, so that everyone can be able to raise their families under strong collective bargaining rights. When we build back better, we will do so with higher wages, including a $15 minimum wage, better benefits and stronger collective bargaining rights that you can raise a family on. That's how we will build back the middle class better than ever, he tweeted. This has left many amused by the good plan Biden and Harris have for the US, and here are some of their reactions. Thank you for listening to this news. You see, it is said that clear conscience fears no accusation. And that is what is happening at present with Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. There is nothing to get themselves worried about when they know that their hands are clean in terms of the election. So what do they need to bother themselves of? Donald Trump can go as far as filing as many cases as possible. What they just need to do is they should just keep on arranging their profile, their agendas to kick off by January. And you can see that that is what they are busy doing. You can see that they never paid attention to the moves Donald Trump is making by filing the case in the court. You can see they are not even moved by his threats. You can see they don't even want to know if he even filed any case. Theirs is to make sure that they do what is expected of them by the United States of America. You see, Donald Trump should understand that United States of America has a constitution, and the constitution, as a president of the country, he has the right to abide by the constitution of that country. And whereby he ends up not abiding by the rules of the constitution, he ends up becoming a defaulter of the constitution. And you must not forget that him too won He equally won the won an election one time ago, and the person he won humbly stepped down for him to take over the White House. So why is he now finding it difficult to relinquish the position for Biden? Why is he now thinking and believing that there was a foul play or a fraud in the election? What makes him feel that? Who has furnished him with those lies? According to the FBI that monitored the election day, they testified that they said this is the best election ever conducted in the United States. There was no fraud experienced on the day of the election. So what are we saying? Where has Donald Trump gotten his own facts? Where has he gotten his own facts? I said before that taking this case to court is a waste of time and a waste of resources, and that is what Donald Trump is just doing now. That's what he's just doing, and it won't pay him. It won't pay him one bit. Instead, it will cost him more money, more waste of time. You understand? So, my viewers, I don't know what Donald Trump is actually up to, but one thing I believe for sure is that he doesn't want to leave that presidential position. He doesn't want to. He just wants to make sure he completes that that 2-term as a president, which cannot be possible anymore because he has single-handedly used his own hand to kill his administration. He killed his administration. He murdered his opportunity. The opportunity of becoming a president again was murdered. So whose fault is that? It's his fault and no other person's fault. My viewers, please, you really need to come into this matter because it really, really concerns you and it will really go a long way. Alright? So please deem it fit to leave your comments below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as play buttons to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.